Hello friends, welcome to Awdhesh Academy. Friends, in the year 2019, some case studies has been asked which are relating to the contemporary issues in the governance. And one of the contemporary issue of the government is politicization of the bureaucracy. If the bureaucracy, instead of doing their jobs in the legal and proper manner, get aligned with the political parties, politicians, and become a committed bureaucracy who will listen to the master's voice and do the act as the politicians say, that can be quite detrimental to the society. So in 2019, a case study has been asked on this particular topic. So let us now read the case study. In a modern democratic polity, there is a concept of the political executive and permanent executive. Elected people's representative forms the political executive and bureaucracy forms the permanent executive. Ministers frame policy decisions and bureaucrats execute these. In the initial decades after independence, the relationship between the permanent executive and political executives were characterized by mutual understanding, respect, and cooperation without encroaching upon each other's domain. However, in the subsequent decades, the situation has changed. There are instances of political executive insisting upon the permanent executive to follow its agenda. Respect for and appreciation of upright bureaucrats has declined. There is an increasing tendency among the political executive to get involved in the routine administrative matters such as transfers, postings, etc. Under this scenario, there is a definitive trend towards politicization of the bureaucracy. The rising materialism and acquisitiveness that is greed in social life has also adversely impacted upon the ethical values of both the permanent executive and the political executive. So the question is as following. What are the consequences of this politicization of the bureaucracy? Discuss. Now in this particular case study, we have to discuss about the impact, consequences, and ramification of the politicization of the bureaucracy. So let us now go ahead and solve this particular case study. In this particular type of case study, let us first talk about the meaning of democracy. Democracy means the rule of the people. Democracy is a system of government in which the citizens exercise their power through elected representatives among themselves to form the governing body such as parliament. So the people elect their leaders in the elections. They elect MPs and MLAs who basically go to the parliament or state legislator, and they basically run the government of the country. Democracy is also sometimes referred to as the rule of the majority, because the political party which has got more number of MLAs and MPs who can form the government. The government in a democracy basically consists of, number one, political executive, who are ministers chosen among the elected representatives like MP and MLAs. And the second is the permanent executive, like the civil servants who are selected by independent constitutional or statutory bodies like UPSC, PSC, SSC, etc. Now, what is the role of the political executive? The political executives like MP and MLAs are basically elected by the people for a duration of 5 years. The elections are held every 5 years and they are chosen for a period of 5 years. Some of them become the minister and head the government ministries and the department. And head is the chief minister or the prime minister. They are basically the administrative head of the ministry with the power of superintendence and the administration of the bureaucracy. So the minister is the top person in a particular ministry, and all the civil servants has to report and work under the minister. The minister, as member of parliament or member of legislative assembly, they are responsible for making laws, rules, and procedures through the parliament and through their own ministries. So these are the roles of the political executive. Now, as far as the permanent executive or civil servant's role is concerned, it is as following. First of all, the civil servants are selected through the competitive examination by following the procedures which are prescribed by the government. So we know there is a civil service examination through which the top level civil servants are selected in India. They are appointed against a permanent post and they work till their retirement. They assist the ministers in drafting and making of the laws. So even though the laws are passed by the parliament and state legislature, the bureaucrats play an important role in drafting of those laws. They are also responsible for the implementation of the laws made by the parliament and the state legislature. Once the law is made, then the bureaucrats implement them as district magistrate, SP or tax commissioner and so many other posts. They are the people who implement the law. And they are expected to work independently in accordance with the law. While implementation of the law is concerned, the civil servants are not expected to consult and work under the minister's pressure or basically minister's direction. They must implement the work according to the law. Since ministers are supervising them, therefore, the constitution has given protection to the civil servants so that they can work independently. Accordingly, they cannot be removed from service unless they are engaged in corruption or found inefficient. And even if suppose a minister wants to remove them, due process of law has to be followed for appointment and removal of the civil servant. And they will have the mechanism to go to the court and get themselves restored if they have been removed wrongly. Their pay, promotion and perks are protected by the constitution. And so with this level of protection, it is expected that the civil servants must work freely and independently. However, unfortunately, politicization of the bureaucracy is also a reality. And the main reason is that the bureaucrats assume power and position based on their posting. So if you get the posting of district collector or let us say SP or tax commissioner, you enjoy power. And if you are given a charge where you don't have power, then you don't enjoy any power. And in this matter, the politicians have the absolute power to transfer these civil servants. They can post you and therefore they can give you power, they can make you powerless. Now, frequent transfers affect the personal life of the civil servants and it can cause a huge inconvenience to the civil servant. Civil servants may face harassment also if they don't heed the direction of the politicians, because ultimately the politicians are supreme in the democracy and they can even remove or compulsory retire the civil servants in the extreme cases. It is for this reason that civil servants are scared of the politicians and they often follow the direction of the politicians. But if they don't do their work honestly and according to the law, it can have a severe consequences, because the politicization of the bureaucracy is very, very harmful for the country. So what could be the consequence of the politicization of the bureaucracy? Let us understand. Politicians often engage in divide and rule policy to get votes, because a politician who gets even 40% vote may come into power. And therefore, they often divide the society on the basis of the caste, creed, reason, language, and they try to get votes. They often act in a partition manner to please their vote bank, because if they can take care of the majority population, they can come to power and they can enjoy power. Therefore, they often don't treat every citizen on the equal footing. At the same time, the politicians need huge funds to fight the elections. And when they get those funds from unscrupulous elements, they have to protect them once they come into power. On the other hand, civil servants are selected on the basis of their merit through the competitive examination, and their job is secured till their retirement. Therefore, civil servants provide fair administration and implement the law impartially. If there is a politicization of the bureaucracy, that can alienate a large segment of the society due to their unfair treatment, because the civil servant will also favor a particular segment or group of the society, and as a result, what will happen, that a large number of people can be alienated. Civil servants also feel demoralized if there is a lot of political interference, because they will not be able to work independently. They may also fear decision making in accordance with the law due to political repercussion. Suppose an SP takes an action against a politician's close person who is committing crime, he may feel that he may be transferred or may be punished. So if the political interference is there, politicization of the bureaucracy is there, then such actions will not be possible and the people who are close to the power will become bigger than the law. Gradually, the citizens will lose faith in the government due to the unfair treatment meted to different class of the society. And therefore, politicization of the bureaucracy will diminish the rule of law and it will create anarchy in the future. So these are the consequences of the politicization of the bureaucracy. So friends, this is a very interesting contemporary question which has been asked in this examination, and I hope that you got a good answer of this particular question. Please practice this question and that will help you writing better answers in the civil service examination. Thank you very much.